गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम ECB 401 इंडियन इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी का लास्ट टॉपिक फूड प्रॉब्लम इन इंडिया, इसमें हम फूड सिक्योरिटी के बारे में पढ़ेंगे, रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट अगेंस्ट फूड प्रॉब्लम इसके बारे में पढ़ेंगे. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट द टॉपिक, व्हाट इज फूड प्रॉब्लम इन इंडिया. फूड, क्लॉथिंग एंड शेल्टर आर द बेसिक नेसेसिटीज ऑफ अ पर्सन. एमंग दीज, फूड इज द फर्स्ट मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट नेसेसिटी. नो वन कैन सर्वाइव विदाउट सफिशियंट फूड. इट इज़ अ प्राइम ड्यूटी ऑफ एवरी गवर्नमेंट टू प्रोवाइड सफिशियंट फूड टू ऑल द पीपल ऑफ अ स्टेट. इफ अ गवर्नमेंट फेल्स टू प्रोवाइड सफिशियंट एंड नरिशिंग फूड टू हर पीपल, शी फेल्स ऑन ऑल द इकोनॉमिक, सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल फ्रंट्स. देयरफॉर सफिशियंट फूड शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड टू ऑल द पीपल्स ऑफ अ स्टेट. Production of a food grains should be sufficient to meet their demand. If the production is less than demand, the country will have to import food grains, which will create the problem of adverse balance of trade and balance of payments. In India, food problem is a chronic problem. It dates back to 1937, the time of separation of Burma from India, and 1947, the time of partition. Unemployment has further aggravated the problem. What is the nature of food problem with different aspects in India? India is the second most populated country of the world. Being so, requirements, food requirements of the country are increasing day by day. Food problem in India covers four important aspects. First is quantitative aspects. Quantitative aspects of food problem are related to the demand and supply of food grains. Production of food grains has been less than their demand for a long period. Though in the last few years, domestic production of food grains has increased considerably, yet the country has to import food grains in large quantities from time to time. Qualitative aspects. Qualitative aspect of food problem is related to nutritive elements in food. Proteins, vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates, etc. are the important elements of a balanced diet, but these elements are not available in sufficient quantities to most of the Indian people. According to experts, a person should get 3000 calories per day, but an average 2100 calories are available to the people in India. Most important reason of this situation is the poverty of the most of the people in India. Distributive aspect of the food problem are related to the system of marketing of agriculture products. Due to defective system of distribution, most of the persons do not get food grains in sufficient quantities at right time and at fair prices. Antisocial elements create artificial shortage of these products in market and sell them at unreasonable prices. Most important reason for this situation is administrative sluggishness. Economic aspects of food problem are related to purchasing power of people. National income and per capita income of India are very low. The result is that most of the people in India are not in a position to afford the purchase of nourishing food grains in sufficient quantities. Now, let us discuss what are the causes of food problem in India. Important causes of food problem in India are as follows. First, rapid growth of population. Low agricultural productivity, natural calamities, development of commercial crops, changes in the consumption pattern, increase in income demand for food, economic development and urbanization, hoarding and black marketing. Now, let us discuss what is food security. Food is the essential for living as air is breathing. But food security means something more than getting two square meals. Food security has following dimensions. First, availability, accessibility and affordability. Availability of food means food production within the country, food imports and the previous year's stock stored in government granaries. Accessibility means food is within reach of every person. Affordability means implies that an individual has enough money to pay sufficient, safe and nutritious food to meet one's dietary needs. Thus, food security is ensured in a country only if enough food is available for all the persons. All persons have capacity to buy of acceptable quail, and there is no barrier on access to food. Now, why food security? The poorest section of the society might be food insecure. Most of the times, while persons have the poverty line, might also be food insecure. When the country faces a national disaster, calamity like earthquake, drought, flood, tsunami, widespread failure of crops, causing famine, etc. How is food security? Due to a natural calamity, say drought, total production of food grains decreases. It creates a shortage of food in the affected areas. Due to shortage of food, the price goes up at the high prices. Some people cannot afford to buy food. If such calamity happens in a very widespread area, or is stretched over a longer time period, it may cause a situation of saturation. A massive starvation might take a turn of famine. A famine is characterized by widespread deaths due to starvation and epidemic caused by forced use of contaminated water or decaying food and loss of body resistance due to weakening from starvation. The most devastating famine that occurred in India was the famine of Bengal. In 1943, this famine killed 30 lakh people in the province of Bengal. What are the role of government? What is the role of government against food problem? Promoting domestic production to meet the demands of the growing population. Providing minimum support prices for procures and storage of food grains. Implementation of PDS, targeted public distribution system, to put buffer stock. What are the pillars of food security? WHO states that there are three pillars that determine food security: food availability, food access, and food use. The FAO adds a fourth pillar, the stability of the first three dimensions of food security over time. In 2009, the World Summit of Food Security started the four pillars of food security are availability, access, utilization, and stability. Suggestions. Food policy of Government of India. What are the suggestions? Food policy of Government of India. Soon after independence, the government took the problem of shortage of food grains seriously. Several important measures have been taken by government to solve this problem. Increase in production of food grains. Agriculture development has been accorded top priority in almost all the 5-year plans. Several programs have been launched to increase agricultural production and productivity, such as intensive farming, multi-crop programming, development of high-yielding variety of seeds, intensive use of fertilizers, etc. Next, import of food grains. To meet the shortage of food grains, the government has been importing food grains from time to time. Next, procurement of food grains. Government adopted the system of procurement of food grains. Under this system, government procures food grains from market every year. For this purpose, procurement prices or minimum support prices are announced by government every year for all the important food grains, and all the government purchases are made at these prices. It helps in protecting farmers against the malpractices of traders and commissions agents. Public distribution of food grains. Government adopted public distribution system to ensure fair distribution of food grains at controlled prices. Under this system, fair price shops are opened. Each such shops is to serve a population of about 2000. As on 31st March 1998, there were about 4.50 lakh fair price shops, ration shops in the country. These shops supply rice, wheat, sugar, edible oils, and kerosene to people in certain quantity at controlled prices. Buffer stock schemes. In buffer stock scheme, government started a scheme of maintaining buffer stock of important food grains to ensure their regular supply throughout the year. Whenever there is a rise in their prices, government releases them from buffer stock to stabilize prices. Buffer stock operations are normal these days, and they have become a normal part of the food policy of Government of India. Establishment of specific institutions. A number of specific institutions have been established by government to promote agricultural production and productivity and ensure regular supply and fair distribution of food grains. Important institutions are National Seeds Corporation, Agro Industry Corporation, Agricultural Prices Commission, Food Corporation of India, Fertilizer Corporation of India, etc. Agricultural Research and Development. Government is taking serious steps to promote agricultural research and development. Public distribution system, जो कि हम इससे पहले पढ़ चुके हैं, public distribution system means the regulated and controlled distribution of essential goods among people. Under this system, essential consumer goods are provided to people at fair prices through government agencies. Main constitutions of public distribution system are fair prices shops or ration shops, consumer cooperative stores, shop selling cloth at controlled prices. These shops sell cloth at controlled prices to consumer on the basis of their ration cards. Super bazaar also, which provide all the goods of daily needs at controlled prices. Kerosene retailers. In some states, kerosene is distributed through fair price shops. Next, commodity of distributions. Six key essential commodities, wheat, rice, sugar, imported edible oils, kerosene and soft coke, are distributed to consumers through public distribution system. Responsibility of supply of commodities. Different institutions have been assigned the responsibility of procurement, allocation and distribution of different goods as under Food Corporation of India for wheat, rice and other food grains, Indian Oil Corporation and Ministry of Petroleum of Kerosene, Coal India Limited for soft coke, National Textile Corporation and State Trading Corporation for imports for food grains, government purchasing of food grains and imports of edible oils. Thank you. Have a nice day.